ದಿವ್ಯ ಬೃಂದಾರಣ್ಯಕಲ್ಪದ್ರಮಾಧ ಶ್ರೀಮದ್ ರತ್ನಾಗಾರ ರತ್ನ ಸಿಂಹಾಸನಸ್ಥೌ ಶ್ರೀಮದ್ ರಾಧಾ ಶ್ರೀಲ್ ಗೋವಿಂದ ದೇವೌ ಪ್ರೇಷ್ಠಾಲೀಭಿ ಸೇವ್ಯ ಮಾನೌ ಸ್ಮರಾಮಿ ಶ್ರೀಮಾನ್ ರಾಸ ರಸಾರಂಭಿ ವೈಶೀವಟ್ಟಟಸ್ಥಿತ ಕರ್ಷನ್ ವೇಣುಸ್ವಲೈರ್ ಗೋಪಿ ಗೋಪೀನಾಥ ಶ್ರೀಯೋಸ್ತು ನಾರಾಯಣ ನಮಸ್ಕೃತ್ಯ ನರಂ ಚೈವ ನರೋತ್ತಮಂ ದೇವೀಂ ಸರಸ್ವತೀಂ ವ್ಯಾಸಂ ತತೋ ಜಯಮುದೀರಯೇತ್ ವಾಂಛಾಕಲ್ಪತರುಭ್ಯಶ್ಚ ಕೃಪಾ ಸಿಂಧುಭ್ಯೇವ ಚ ಪತ್ತಾನಾಂ ಪಾವನೇಭ್ಯೋ ವೈಷ್ಣವೇಭ್ಯೋ ನಮೋ ನಮಃ. ಹೇ ಶ್ರೀ ಸನಾತನ ಪ್ರಭೋ ಕರುಣಾಂಬುರಾಶೆ, ಹೇ ರೂಪ ದುರ್ಗ ಜಯಾವಲೋಕ, ಹೇ ಭಟ್ಟಿಯುಗ್ಮ ಸುಮತೇ ರಘುನಾಥ ದಾಸ, ಶ್ರೀ ಜೀವ ಮೇ ಕುರುತು ಬಂದ ಮತೇ ದಯಾಂದ್ರಾಕ್ ಬುಲಶು ವೃಂದಾವನ್ ಬಿಹಾರಿ ಲಾಲ್ ಕೀ ಜಯ. ಪರಮಂಗಲ ಶ್ರೀ ಶ್ರೀಮದ್ ಭಾಗವತ್ ಮಹಾಪುರಾಣ, ವೆರಿ ವೆರಿ ಆಸ್ಪಿಸಿಯಸ್ ಶ್ರೀ ಶ್ರೀಮದ್ ಭಾಗವತ್ ಮಹಾಪುರಾಣ ಇನ್ ಏಕಾದಶ ಸ್ಕಂಧ. ಪ್ರಿವಿಯಸ್ಲಿ ಶ್ರೀ ಶುಕದೇವ್ ಗೋಸ್ವಾಮಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್ರೈಬ್ ದಟ್ ಶ್ರೀ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ರೀಚಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಶ್ರೀ ಉದ್ಧವ್ ಜಿ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಶ್ರೀ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಈಸ್ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎಸ್ಟಾಬ್ಲಿಷ್ ಥ್ರೀ ಯೋಗ, ಕರ್ಮಯೋಗ, ಜ್ಞಾನಯೋಗ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಭಕ್ತಿಯೋಗ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನಾವ್ ಹೀ ಈಸ್ ಶೋಯಿಂಗ್ ದ ಎಲಿಜಿಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ದೀಸ್ ಥ್ರೀ ಯೋಗ, ಹೂ ಈಸ್ ಎಲಿಜಿಬಲ್ ಟು ದೆಮ್. ಶ್ರೀ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಸಿಂಗ್ ಯದೃಚ್ಛಯ ಮತ್ ಕಥಾದೌ ದ 8th ವರ್ಸೆ ಆಫ್ 20th ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ 8th ವರ್ಸ್. ಯದೃಚ್ಛಯ ಮತ್ ಕಥಾದೌ ಜಾತಶ್ರದ್ಧಸ್ತು ಯಪ್ಪಮಾನ್ ನ ನಿರ್ವಿಣ್ಣೋ ನಾಸಕ್ತೋ ಭಕ್ತಿ ಯೋಗೋಸ್ಯ ಸಿದ್ಧದ. ಯದಿಚ್ಛ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಎ ಗುಡ್ ಫೇತ್, ಗುಡ್ ಫಾರ್ಚೂನ್. ಯಚ್ಛ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಗುಡ್ ಫಾರ್ಚೂನ್. ಇಫ್ ಎ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಸಚ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ಚೂನ್ ಬೈ ದ ಕೈಂಡ್ನೆಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಶ್ರೀ ಗುರುದೇವ್ ಆರ್ ಸಂತ್, ದೆನ್ ಹಿ ವಿಲ್ ಗೇನ್ ಭಕ್ತಿ. Bhakti is always based on the kindness of Shri Gurudev. So yadicha means the kindness. The faith, the fortune that is found due to the kindness. So yadicha means fortune that is found, that can be gotten by the kindness of Shri Gurudev. Kripa prapta saubhagya. That is yadicha. Mat kathadau jata shraddhastu yappaman. If a person having shraddha in my katha, having faith in my katha, na nirvanno nath shakto, and neither he is having the austerity and he is having the renouncement from the material words, and neither he is very much asakt, he is very much involved, or neither he has get the separation from that. For such a person, bhakti yoga se siddhata, only bhakti yoga is Siddhidaha will be beneficial to him. That means Bhakti Yogi cannot get the result of Swarg and his Bhog. Bhog Sukh, Sansar Sukh. So though without Bhakti, Karma Kanda is lamp, as well as without Bhakti, the Gyan Kanda is also lamp. They are not working. Even then, for Bhakti Marg, for a person who is in the middle, for him only the bhakti marga is beneficial, and that will work. Otherwise nothing will work. Bhakti yoga siddhata. So yadicha, but bhakti will be get can be gotten by kindness, and by bhakti, by the kindness, the person will get such fortune. Should do karma to a extent, not up to the last time, whole life, to a extent he will, to a limitation he will do the karma. He should do karma. After that he should accomplish Gyan Yoga and Bhakti Yoga. So tavat karmani kurvito na nirvidyeti yavata. If a person getting the renouncement from the karma, then he can leave karma and he should adopt the Gyan Marga or Bhakti Marga. So karma is only up to that stage when a person has not have interest, have not got the interest in Bhakti Yoga and Karma Yoga, Gyan Yoga. In Bhakti Yoga and Gyan Yoga, if he has not adopted, he has not achieved the interest, so far he should do the karma. Tavat karmani kurvito. Tavat man, this is the limit of karma. Na nirvidyeti yavata. From the worldly attraction, he is not getting nirved. That means unattachment. Or the he is not involving in that. So tavat karmani kurvito na nirvidya. Nirvid means he has not becomes uninterested. Nirvid means uninterested. So a jnani while he will entering in the Gyan Marga, he will leave the interest in karma, but he will not leave the karma physically. He will leave only the karma, this idea that by karma I can get the perfection. He will leave this idea. So tavat karmani kurvito. So firstly he is very much interested in karma, then first of all he will leave the interest. Then while he is accomplishing Gyan Yoga, then even then he will not leave karma physically. He will continue karma. Yes, yes. Because if he will leave karma, then it is there will be the possibility that some sin came and make him falling downward. So he will not leave the varnashram dharma, but while he will get siddhi, perfection in jnan, then he will leave the karma physically. So while he is entering in the karma jnan yoga, then he will leave the interest and he will leave this idea that by karma I can get the perfection. And karma is a good accomplishment. He will leave this idea. Karma mein sadhan buddhi ka tyag. The karma is a good accomplishment of accomplishment to get the perfection. This sadhan buddhi, he will only leave. While he is doing Gyan Marga also, at that time also, he will not leave the karma. Kyunki karma eva sansiddhim astita jankadeha lok sangraham evapi sampashyan kartum arhati. In Bhagavad Gita, Shri Krishna is saying that karmane naiva sansiddhim astrita jankadeha. Janak adi, janak etc., they have not left karma perfectly. And by karma, they got sansiddhi even. By accomplishing karma, they got the perfection also, because karma always protect them from sin, from the undesirable activities. So karma marga is very much important, because it protects us from sin, and it always promotes us for the pious activities, for the sattvic activities, and by sattva gyan it will increase. So while they are in the beginning, they are entering in the gyan marga, then they will leave the interest in karma. While they are performing and accomplishing gyan marga, then even then they will not leave karma physically. They will do nitya karma, but they will leave kamya karma. That means desirable karma they will leave. So fruitful karma, fruit giving karma, sakam karma, they will leave them. But while they will get the perfection in gyan, then they will leave the karma physically also. So that these are the three things. First, theoretically they will leave karma, then they will accomplish karma, but they will not think that by this karma we can get the perfection, and then physically they will leave the karma. So tavat karmani kurvito na nirvidyeti yavata. Nirvid means while he is having unattachment with karma, then he should he can leave the karma. That means perfection. Yes, yes, perfection is not mukti, but jivan mukti. A realization in tense position he has achieved. In tense position he has achieved the realization, but not perfect. Still, his designations are not gone. The upadhi is still with him. Designations are also with him. So that means his body is not left so far. At that time, he can leave karma. So tavat karmani kurvito na nirvidyeti yavata. While he will get nirved, that means uninterest in karma, he, up to that position, he should accomplish karma. But in bhakti, it is very much interesting, and bhakti is very much beneficial, that if a person have matkatha shronadu va, if a person is having the interest in, or the faith in, faith, not interest, faith, a person is having faith in Krishna katha, even then he can leave karma. So shuddha yavanda jayate, as soon as a person get the shuddha in bhagavad bhakti, faith in bhagavad bhakti, then he can leave the karma, and he will not be punished for that. That means if he has taken initiation from Gurudev, and now he is not performing his varnashram dharma, but not sin. He is not perfecting the yajna, daily yajna. He is not performing them. Even then, he will not be punished, because he has accepted Bhagavad Bhakti, and he is now doing the chanting of Harinam. But if a person is not, neither he is doing Harinam, neither he is doing bhakti, and if he leaves the karma, then he will be punished. That is the thing. Mat katha shramanadu va, Shuddha Yavanna Jayate. That means if a person has entered in the Bhakti Marg, because the entrance in Bhakti Marg is found by Shrava. It begins by Shrava. The entrance in Bhakti Marg begins by Shrava. So Mat Katha Shrava Duva. He is having the interest in Shrava and also having the Shuddha. Then he can leap karma from the very beginning. So this is the difference, that in Jnana Marg, a person will leave the karma at the perfection position. But in Bhakti Marg, he is allowed to leave the karma. Even then, he will not leave. Normally, a person will not leave the prescribed works. He will adopt them. But he can leave the karmas. Karma. If he has the Shraddha in Shrava. Matkatha Shravanadu. So that is different. Again, it should be very much clear. Tavat karmani kurvito na nirvidyeti yavata. If a person is entering in the Gyan realm, Gyan Chetra, Gyan ke bare mein, in the field of Gyan, if he is entering, then he can leave the interest for karma. That means theoretically he is not interested in karma. Even then he is not leaving karma. Now the second position comes. The jnani is accomplishing the jnan sadhan. That means Shravan, Smaran, Manan, Sasad, Vivek, Ihamusha, Phalbhoktiyag. Sasad, Vivek means what is true and what is wrong, false. He has the discretion of it. The first thing is Sasad, Vivek. Phir Ihamusha, Phalbhoktiyag. He is not interested in the result of his karma, either here or on Swarg. Ehamush Phalbhoktiyag. That is the second. Sarsad Vivek Ehamush Phalbhoktiyag. The third thing is Shamadi Shat Sampatti. He has doing six activities according to Gyan Marg. And these six activities are Sham Dam Titiksha, Uparati, Samarhan, or Shraddha. These are the six things. Gradually, respectively, their meaning is Sham means he is leaving the interest in Shabda Sparsha Rupa Rasa Gandha. Sham means calling back his senses from Shabd Sparsha Rupa Rasa Gandha, that is Sham. The senses are going toward the objects, but the person is always trying to check them. So Sham means to check them going toward the worldly material things. That is Sham. Dham means if the Indri has not accepting our order, then a person will punish them. That is Dham. He will say, oh my man, oh my mind, I have adopted you. You have not adopted me. If you are not following me, I will punish you. That is Dham. Sham means the trying, the preaching to check them. Oh my man, please do not go there. That is Sham. And Dham, oh, if you are not following me, then you will be punished. That is Dham. Sham and Dham. Titiksha. Titiksha means a person is getting an uncomfortable position. Even then, he will not live his way. That is titiksha. Titiksha means tolerance of the sorrowness. That is titiksha. A person is chastising him, but even then he is tolerating it. Feeling thirst or hunger, even then he is controlling it. That is titiksha. Shramdram titiksha. Uparati. Uparati means if a bhog, if or if a thing is achieved to him, he is getting that thing, even then he is not using it. Getting the very good meal, but he is not accepting it. No, today is my birth, I will not take it. That is. So, shabdisparsha, there is very much good music. No, I will not listen it because I have to do my chanting in this way. So, sham, dam, titiksha, uparati. Sham means checking from the objects. Dam means punishing our senses. Titiksha means tolerating the difficulties. Titiksha. Uparati, that means not if the things are gotten even then he is leaving them and he is not using them. Uparati. Samadhan. Samadhan means ashtang yoga. He will do yam, niyam, asan, pranayam, pratyahar, dharana, dhyan, samadhi. So samadhan means samadhi. And shuddha means bhagavad bhakti. The mukhya, main thing is he is also accomplishing bhagavad bhakti. So if he is doing these six things, then these are samadhi sasampatti. And the fourth thing is mumuksha. That means he is always having moksha, icha, the desire of moksha. That is also important. So, mumuksha, that is, a bhakti never want mumuksha, he want to serve Shri Krishna. He is not wanting the freedom, but bhakti, a jnani, is always with moksha icha. He has the desire of moksha. So these are the sadhana of jnana. So if a person is doing, accomplishing these four sadhana, sasad vivek, ehamushya phalbhog tyag, sham, etc., six ways, six sadhana, and moksha kamna, the desire of moksha. If he is doing this, even then he will not leave the karma. Tavat karman kurvita nan nirvidyet. So physically he will not leave karma, but he will not be interested, neither he will be interested in karma, or neither he will think that by this karma I can get the achievement. He only practice them so that the sin and other anti-activities are not suppressing me, and I can save from those activities. So matkatha shramadu, and while he will become perfect, that means in transposition, he will think himself to be Brahma. He will be in samadhi, then he will naturally, he will leave the karma. So, but in bhakti, it is very much important matkatha shramadu va shuddhaya vanna jayate. As soon as a person have the shuddha, he can leave karma kand for his bhakti. Because if he will not leave karma kand, then how he will get the renowned system of life? Shri Rup Sanatan, they all have left their house. So he cannot leave that. That means if he has interest in bhagavad bhakti, or he has shravan, nishtha in shravan, shraddha in shravan, then he will go, he will leave the karma marg physically also. As Rupa Sanatana has left the karma marg physically also. So a normal grahasthi, a household will not leave karma marg, but if he has left the he has the drudh shuddha, then he can leave the karma kanda. If he has taken, he has become babaji, then he will leave karma kanda. And if he is grahasthi, then he will also follow karma kanda, but he will not be very much faithful to having the faith in them, because he knows that by this karma kanda I cannot get the perfect result. Whatever I shall get, that will be achieved only by chanting Shri Harinam, only by doing Bhagavad Bhakti, not by this karma. But this karma is also associating, assisting my bhakti. So he will do the karma kanda as bhakti, as a part of bhakti, not separately. And he does not have the faith in that karma kanda, he have the faith in bhakti only. So mat katha shramadova shuddha yavan na jayate. If the shuddha is not very much perfect, then he should perform karma. If the shuddha is perfect, even he should do karma. But having this idea that by this karma I will not get the lotus feet of Shri Krishna, those can be achieved only by Bhagavad Bhakti. But this Shastra Bhed karma, the prescribed works of prescribed karma of Shastra, those will be helpful in my Bhagavad Bhakti. So he will also, he will not leave the karma physically. But if the karma is left, now the third thing, that is this, that if the karma is left, even then he need not to do prayaschit for that. He will not do prayaschit. He will do Bhagavad Bhakti. The karma is left, so he will not be in the circle, in the round of karma. He will do Bhagavad Bhakti. And by Bhagavad Bhakti, everything will be accomplished, everything will be perfect, fulfilled. So mat katha shravanadu shraddha yavan na jayate. If he has shraddha and he is not doing karma, for neglecting karma he will not be punished, and neither he is expected to do prayaschit for those karma. So that is the main thing, because bhakti will accomplish everything. Even then, for his satisfaction, if a person is doing prayaschit, then those prayaschit will be very much mild. Those will not be very much hard. Krucha prayaschit are not permissible in Bhagavad Bhakti Marga. Only a slight prayaschit that is done, he will do Ganga Snan, he will give up his hairs, he will give some offering, dan, but not the very much prayaschit. He will not do those repentances much more. Swadharmasto yajan yagyai anashi kamuddhava nayat swarga nargau yadyanyannam samachare. Swadharmasto yajan yagyai. A person is doing yajna and he is following swadharma, nishdharma, anashi kam, and he is not having the desire. A person is performing karma even, though he is bhakta or jnani, even then he is performing karma. So dharmasto jaren yagyai, anashi. But his karma will be without any desire, anashi. So he will do karma without the desire of a fruit, getting the fruit. So unfruitive karma he will do, unfruitive karma, nishkam karma. So dharmasto jaren yagyai, anashi. Kama, and neither he has any desire, neither he will accomplish unfruitive works and anashi, nishkam, neither he will have the desire. Nayati swarga narakam, such a person will not go neither to swarga, neither to narak. So he has not accomplished the work for swarga and narak. Yadi anyat na samacharit. But one thing is very much important, that he should not do the pap karma. Sinful activities are not allowed in every position. He should always be beware of sinful activities. So without accomplishing sinful activities, he should do Bhagavad Bhakti. Yadi anyat na samacharit. Anyat means the sinful activities he will not accomplish. So again, swadharmastho yajan. A person should accomplish his varnashram dharma. Yajna, he should also accomplish yajna. But this should be anashi. Without fruitiveness, he is not accomplished them to get the fruit of that. So he will unfruitive karma he will do. Nishkam karma he will do. And kama, neither he will have any desire to against those works. Such a person who is only doing the work by half-heartedly, then nayat swarga narakam, he will not go neither swarga neither narak. Yadi anyatna samacharit, if he is not doing the sinful activities, if he is doing sinful activities, then he should be ready to and Shri Harinam will excuse him from all bandhan. Asmin loke vartamanah swadharmastho naghas shuchi jnanam vishuddham apnoti mad bhaktim va yadichaya. In this way, asmin loke vartamanah, a person who is living in this loke, swadharmastha, and he is accomplishing his karma kand, his karma marga also, not leaving the karma physically. Swadharmastho anagha shuchi, and he is not doing the sinful activities. And shuchi, he is normally leading his life very shuchi, very purely. That means shuddhi ashuddhi, he is also adopting them. Jnanam vishuddham apnoti, he will get the jnana. Mad bhaktim ba yadichya, and he will also get the mad bhakti yadichya by the saubhagya, by the fortune of kindness. Shri Gurudev will be kindful, and due to that kindness we will get the fortune to do bhakti. So yadichya, yadichya means kindness or fortune. Left grihasthi, ghar, and he has adopted the, became the babaji, then he can leave karma. But if a person is in grihasthi, then thinking that I am still grihasthi, I have not left my home, so I should do karma, but this karma will not lead me, will not lead me to the perfection. Whatever I shall get by Bhagavad Bhakti. But this sattvic karma or varnashram karma will be helpful in my bhakti also. So in this way, he will perform karma, but not having that by this karma I can get any fruit. The fruit is only this, that they will help full in Bhagavad Bhakti. Bas only. But he will not lead physically karma. He will do every karma, every varna ashram dharma, as well as the purity and impurity, the description of shuddhi, ashuddhi. He will adopt all this, all the things. And by adopting them, he will be able to do his bhakti better. So in this way, he will adopt the karma, but having the whole emphasis on Bhagavad Bhakti, not on karma. He will do karma having this idea that this karma is helpful only. But by this karma, I cannot get the moksha. The moksha or bhakti will be adopted only by the serving of Shri Krishna or Jnana. So Jnanam Vishuddham Apnoti Madhbhaktim Ba Yadchya Asmin Loke Vartamana Swadharmastho Anagashuchi. A person who is living in this world, he is Swadharmastha, he is accomplishing his Varnashram Dharma and Anagaha, he is not doing the sinful activities, and he is Shuchi, he is very much pure, and having the what is pure and what is impure. So by Shuddhi Ashuddhi, adopting this, he will get a Jnana or Bhakti. Swarguno Pyetat Michanti Loke Narayana Sataha Sadhakam Jnana Bhakti Bhyam Uvyam Yada Sadhakam. Swarguno Pyetat Michanti, this human body is very much fruitful. So Swarguna, even Devata, deities also want to get this human body. This human body is very much precious, and even Devata, demigods want to get this human body. Lokam niranastatha, in the same way, who are feeling, who are experiencing, witnessing the punishment of Narak, they are also wants to get this human body. So this human body is very much important. The human are of two types. One is Charshani and other is Manushya. Charshani means a person who can do activities. He is called only Charshani. But he can do, he will not stay spare for a moment even. He will do any at every time some activities are he is doing, and such person is doing is called Charshani. Charshani means he is full of activities. He is very much active. So the active man is called Charshani. But every activeness is not fruitful. Every activeness is will not lead us to the higher position. The manushya is that person who is acting to get the moksha or the fruit of this real fruit of this life, that is called manushya. So there is, in this way, every manushya charshani, but every charshani is not manushya. A person who have the activities, he is not manushya. But the manushya is who is always beware, full of vigilance, that how I can get the higher position. A nishreyas, a person who is trying to get nishreyas, he is manushya, and a person who is only doing activities, he is charshani. Is it clear? So, a devata is also wanting, also wishing to be a human, manushya. Sadhakam jnan bhaktabhyam uvyam tad sadhakam. This human body is sadhakam bhakti jnanabhyam. It is the sadhak of bhakti and jnan. Uvyam tad asadhakam. And swarga narak tad asadhakam. Only they will not be achieved by jnan or bhakti. By jnan bhakti, a person will get moksha. So sadhakam jnan bhakti kam. So by jnan and bhakti, he will get the perfection. He will get the moksha. But ubhayam tad asadhakam. But jnan and bhakti, they cannot be, they are not given, they will not result the swarga and narak. Jnan, by jnan and bhakti, neither a person will get swarga, neither a person will get narak, but he will get the service of Shri Krishna. Ubhayam tat asadhakam. Ubhayam means swarga narak. Tad asadhakam. That means that swarga and narak will not be achieved by jnana and bhakti. So only by having the body, a person cannot get jnana bhakti. He has to practice jnana bhakti. Unless a person is not getting, is only getting body, and he is not working for jnana and bhakti, then he will not get the service of Shri Krishna, neither he will get the salvation. So only by having body or getting body, yes, nar body, nar de. So only getting nar de, it is not the goal. A person can get nar body, even then he is not, if he is not practicing bhakti or jnana, then he will not get the perfection, moksha. So though, again, swargalopi etat ichanti, this human body is so much precious that even the deities want this body. Clear? Lokam narayanam tatha. Lokam means this body is also desired by the narayana, by the persons who are in the hell. So from the person who are in swarg, heaven, or in hell, both want this body. Sadhakam bhakti jnanabhyam. Because the value of this body is due to that by this body a person can do jnana or bhakti, because this is the main instrument of doing jnana and bhakti. So devata also want it, and the narak papijan also want to get this human body. But ubhayam tad sadhakam. But only by getting body, a person cannot perform jnana or bhakti. Because if he is not doing the activities of jnana or activities of bhakti, and he has got in the human body, so there are thousands of persons of this type, that they have human body, but they are not using it, utilizing it. They are not using the proper utilization of their body. So he is saying ke ubhayam tad sadhakam. By this human body, jnana and bhakti, that is only by getting the human body we will get the jnana and bhakti. It is not possible. We have to take shelter of Gurudev and we have to practice for them, then only we can get the jnana and bhakti. So only getting the human body, it is not the whole thing. Something is still rest to perform the jnana and bhakti. Uvyam tad sadhakam. So this body is sadhakam jnana bhakti vyam, is very much useful for jnana and bhakti. Even then, uvyam tad asadhakam. Only by getting human body, one cannot achieve jnana or bhakti unless he is doing practice for that and he is getting the kindness of Sri Gurudev. Na naras swargatim kaankshet nar kimba vichakshana nemam lokam cha kaankcheto dehabeshat pramadyati. Na naras swargatim kaankshet. A human should not desire that let me reach swarga. He should not, he need not to desire this. Nar kimba vichakshana. Neither he should desire, he should do desiring, desire of going narak. So neither he should desire to swarga, neither he should desire to narak. Because he is vichakshana, he is very much intelligent. Nemam lokam cha kankheto deha beshat pramadyati. And neither a person should desire that let me live long in this human body here. That is also not desired. So nemam lokam cha kankheto, he should not desire this lok also. Because deha beshat pramadyati. If he will remain in the body, then it is possible that he will get the ignorance and pramad. So only living long is not the goal of this life. A person, how long he lived, that is not countable. How he lived, that is countable. The time is not countable. What he has done, that is countable. So nemam lokam cha kaankcheto, a person should not desire this lok even. Because how much a person alive, that is not very important. How he alive, that is much more important. So nemam lokam cha kaankcheto deha beshat pramadyati. If a person will have the involvement in the body only, then pramadyati, he will be get the slackness and he will get the pramad. And by pramad, by the laziness, he can fall down. Only he is living and doing nothing, doing no sadhan, then pramadyati, he can fall down even. So nivam lokam cha kaankcheto deha beshat pramadyati. Etat vidvan puramrtyo avavaya ghatet so apramrtyedam gyatva martam mepyarthi siddhadam. Very important thing. Etat vidvan puramrtyo avavaya ghatet so. If a person is not knowing that what is the goal of my life is, then he will be a loser. Before his death, every person should decide that what is the goal of his life is. If he has not decided, then only by living he cannot get the perfect result. So etat vidvan puram mrityo, before his death a person should decide his goal, and he should know his goal as well as he should try to achieve that goal. Etat vidvan puram mrityo abhavaya ghate saha. So that abhavaya, that means for salvation he can work, he should do this also. So every person should etat vidvan pura mrityo, before his death a person abhavaya ghatet sa should try so that he can get abhav, he can get moksha. Apramatya idam gyatva, and he should be very much conscious. Apramatya idam gyatva martyam, he should always think that this whole sansar is martyam, is maranshil, it will demoshable, it will die, mortal. So apramatyam gyatva martyam, he should know that this world, this whole world is mortal. Idam gyatva martyam api arthasiddhidam, and he should know that though this body is mortal, even then it is siddhidam, it can give the perfection to us. So this body is very much important, but drawback is this, this is mortal. So drawback is this, that this is mortal, but it is arthadam, it can give the perfection. So etat vidvan pura mrityo abhavaya ghate saha, one should be very much conscious, and one should do the activities so that abhavaya ghate saha he can get the salvation. And apramatya idam gyatva, a person knowing this, that very consciously he should know that this body is martyam, mortal, and api arthadam, even then it is the giver of the perfection, arthadam. It provides the fruit. Chiddhimanam yamai etat. In this way, chiddhimanam yamai etat kut nidam vanaspatim khaga swaketa musujyo khemam yati yalam pata. As a farmer is cutting a tree, so as well as he cuts the tree, that birds who are residing there on that on the branches of a tree, they flies away. So chiddhimana yamai, in the same way yamai means the yamdhanaraj, the death is cutting this tree. Krita nidam vanaspatim, here this vanaspati, this tree is being cut by yamdhanaraj. And krita nidam, and here the birds who are residing here and who have the nest in this tree, khaga swaketa musrjyo, immediately the khaga, the birds leaving his home Kshemam Yati, they try to go and try to search a other nest without having interest in that previous home. In the same way, a person should not have the attraction to this body, and he should try to get the kshem, try to get the final destination where he can live easily. That means the lotus feet of Shri Krishna. He should try to go to the lotus feet of Shri Krishna. Tokhaga swaketam usrjya, as a bird leaving his nest flies, and khemam yati, it reaches to the a harmless place. In the same way, a person should also try, so far as our life is with us, at that time, before our death, we should try to get the safest place. And that safest place is the lotus feet of Shri Krishna. Kshemam yati alampata. And we should not be very much lampat. We should not be very much interested, should not have the keen interest in the this body also. So, aho ratri shiddhimanam buddhvayur bhai bepathum mukta sangaha param buddhva niriha upashamyate. It should be understood that aho ratri shiddhimanam, this body is continuously is being cut. Buddhva ayur bhaya bepathu. One should be afraid of his life, of his age, that my age is decreasing every moment. My age is decreasing. So ayur bhayam, this ayu will be finished. And having the bepathu, he should be trembling. Mukta sangha param buddhya, he should be do the sangha of the great persons, and niriha upashamyati, without having the interest in this body, one should upashamyati, one should lead his life very easily, and upashamyati, in this way, leaving the interest in this world, he should live and do the right activities of bhakti or jnana. In this way, Shri Krishna is giving the preachings of vairagya, renouncement. So a person in this way should adopt the vairagya. Bolo Vrindavan Bihari Lal ki jai. Govinda jai jai Gopal jai jai Govinda jai jai Gopal jai jai Radha Ramana Hari Govinda jai jai Radha Ramana Hari Govinda jai jai Shrinitaya Gaura Hari Bol jai jai Shri Krishna.